Yeah, this is just too challenging for me, so I'm staying down here. I mean, I've done my share of grots and caverns and stuff up until very recently, you know. I don't really need to do this one. I get the idea. Also, for where we're staying in Cotignac also. I mean, we're right on the cliff. We're in the cliff in a troglodyte house. And the spouse did the cliff and caves visit, what people can get into, and he said it was pretty energetic and absolutely not for anybody with a fear of heights, you know. At one point he was climbing a metal spiral staircase, which I can see from where we're staying, and he said that was really he's suffering from dizzy spells this year, possibly due to he's legally deaf now in his right ear from his job, and he's getting really violent dizzy spells, which last for hours sometimes. And until that gets sorted out, he was kind of afraid that maybe he shouldn't have gone on the visit, but he was okay. He did about 80 kilometers yesterday in the mountains on a rented bike. He came back like a piece of toast, but he liked it. It's like a rainbow down there at the bottom. This is Villecros in Provence Verte, and today's Friday, and it's our last full day in Cotignac, and then tomorrow we go to Hyères on the Mediterranean, where we had lunch on the way in. I really wasn't feeling well last Saturday. You know, the train ride was 4 hours, and the heat in Toulon was kind of a shock. I don't do well with heat. And then there was quite a car drive, and he was stressing with the rental car as usual. And there was kind of a mediocre lunch. There was, the bathroom was out of order there, but I found a public toilet. And Hyères looks really nice. Very, very quiet. I mean, as in dead. But, you know, people like that. I can understand it. I like it, too. And then there was, like, a good 2-hour drive to Cotignac. It's not really far, but, you know, all the mountain roads and everything. And I was just suffering. Every time we hit a bump, I was just in agony. And it took me about 4 days to recover. Now, after almost a week, I'm sort of getting around, kind of, but I stayed in all afternoon yesterday, really, which is pretty much the only reason I'm able to be here this morning. You know, you get older, you get disabilities, etc., and the same activities are not a good idea, perhaps, or actually you can't do it all. It gets really cold here at night, I must say. That's one thing I've noticed about the Côte d'Azur and Provence, is that even in the blazing sun, you know, it gets very, very hot immediately. As soon as you're in the shade, it's extremely cool. And at night, it gets downright cold. And people always ask me, whoa, could I be homeless down there? I'm like, look, you can forget about being homeless in France. But no. You know, I mean, people die of exposure, like right on the Mediterranean, all year round. You know, it's like if you live in a place that has a desert climate, you know what that's like. You know, it can freeze overnight, no problem. We were both coughing and sneezing furiously the first few days we were here because I don't think that this region of France is a good idea for people who have perhaps hay fever. Oh, let's see if I can get down here. I was able to cure my allergies a few years ago completely, but you know, from the dust and the pollen and stuff, even if you're not actually allergic, it has an effect. It's kind of embarrassing, you know, to be sneezing so much and coughing and wiping your eyes and having to carry numerous handkerchiefs with you and use them constantly. But that's how it goes. We bought some honey on Thursday morning, quite a variety of honey. And the lady's from the United States originally. And she confirmed that the bees are just disappearing here in France. It's very, very depressing. You know, it's like in Sichuan, China for about 20 years now. Humans have to pollinate every little flower on the fruit trees and stuff. Otherwise, there's not going to be anything to eat. Let's see. I think I came this way. I'll go this way. And France is spending a lot of money on this year. And, they're pretty sure that it's not just pesticides, that portable phones and things like that are responsible also. I was writing a letter to a friend in the United States yesterday, and I wrote and I said, you know, it doesn't look good. I'm glad we're getting older and that neither of us had any children. Which is not a cheerful sentiment, I assure you, if you're younger and you're listening to this. No, you don't want to be thinking that or saying that. I guess it's obvious, but take it from me. Whew. Ah, there goes a large lizard. Oh, I think I missed him. I love lizards. Oh, lizards are great. There he goes. Oh, that's a big green one. That's a pretty lizard. All right, I'll leave you alone. See you later.